All right, in this lesson, we'll take a look at how we can match a character by the number of times it occurs. So let's begin by writing out a random test string. It's just going to be a bunch of sequences of the letter Z. So first up, I'm going to write 3 Z's in a row, followed by a space. Then let's do 3 more Z's, then another space, then 2 Z's, then another space, and then 4 Z's in a row. This, of course, is completely random and arbitrary. So let's say I want to target the occurrences of exactly 3 Z's in a row. So there's 3 places where that occurs. Right here, right here, and then right here in the beginning of our 4-character Z string, right? Because remember, any interruption of Z's in a row, such as a space, will break. So we're looking for exactly 3 in a row. Just because this is a sequence of 4 doesn't break the fact that there are 3 Z's to kick things off. So of course, if I simply begin with the character of Z, that's gonna match all of them. But what I can do, as we see right here, is to put a pair of curly braces and specify the number of that character that I want to search for. So in this case, A followed by curly braces with 3 indicates exactly 3 occurrences of the letter A in order. So what I can do here is put a pair of curly braces and inside put 3. So this means exactly 3 occurrences of Z. All right, so it's going to match in 3 places throughout this string. All right, and if I add another Z right here, you can see it's gonna match that. And similarly, if I remove a Z right here, it's no longer gonna match that because now it only has 2 Z's in a row. That space breaks everything up, right? So what if we want to search 3 or more? Well, right here, we can see all we can do is put a comma after that number. So if I have 3 in curly braces, that indicates exactly 3 occurrences of Z in a row. If I put 3 comma, that indicates 3 or more occurrences of Z's in a row. And notice that's going to change the match. For example, these 2 matches are going to be the 3 occurrences of Z in a row. And this complete match right here at the end is going to be the 4 Z's in a row. So you can see here as I scroll down, there's 3 total matches, and this final match is 4 Z's in a row because it's looking for 3 or more in order, and that's what we satisfied here. So no matter how many Z's I add on to the end here, it's going to continue matching it as the final match in sequence, all right? Now, what about searching within a range? Well, what we can do is put a second number after the comma, and that will be the endpoint. So for example, if I put 5, what that is going to indicate is sequences of Z from 3 to 5 in a row, inclusive. So we're gonna match the 3 right here, the 3 right here, and the 4 right here as well. If I add on another Z, that's going to count because now we have 5 Z's in a row. And next, if I put another Z, you'll notice it's not going to count because it can match the 5 here, and this Z is not going to be part of that 5. If I keep adding on, we'll see when I get to 3 again, that fulfills the basic requirements for the regex to recognize another expression of 3 Z's right here in a row after this expression of 5 Z's in a row. So this syntax is going to be any occurrences of Z that are anything between 3 Z's in a row to 5 Z's in a row. So 4 Z's in a row is always going to be included there as well. Here's your proof of that. All right, that's all there is to cover in this lesson. So I will see you in the next one.